The world's largest democracy, India, expects the largest economy in the world, United States of America, to put its money where it works. Crippled by congested ports and poor road network, India has made a fresh bid for attracting U.S. investment in infrastructure sector to the visiting U.S. Treasury Secretary, Timothy Geithner. The wish list this time around is $600 billion.
I have had discussions, particularly when we have the discussions on infrastructure sectors. Immense possibilities are there for making investment in infrastructure sectors. In fact, in 5-year period, more than $600 billion could be invested in port, in road, in communications.
With Indian economy emerging as one of the fastest growing economies after China, US is eager for strengthening ties with India. This assumes significance given the fact that the US dispute with China over undervaluation of Chinese currency remain unresolved, and US may look at a possible India support in international forums like WTO. Meanwhile, US is pressing India to open up its highly regulated financial sector for US-based insurance companies, banks and retailers. In return, India wants greater US support for flexing its financial muscles in forums like G20.
Two of the world's largest economies, we need to work more closely together. Our ability to cooperate on economic and financial issues will be critically important to the success of global efforts to create conditions for a more stable global financial system, more balanced global economic growth, more effective and representative international financial institutions, and a more open global trading system.
The two-day visit will conclude with U.S. Treasury Secretary meeting business leaders in Mumbai on Wednesday. This meeting is seen crucial for enhancing bilateral trade with the U.S. Although trade between the two countries has doubled in the past, but it is still lesser in comparison to U.S. trade with China and Europe. The newly formed partnership, which will have regular cabinet-level India-U.S. meetings, is expected to clear the policy hurdles for better capital flows and easier foreign investment in infrastructure. Himani Kaushik, Bloomberg UTV, New Delhi.